My name is Amy Mainzer, and I'm a research scientist at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. Right now I'm working on a project called the Wide Field Infrared Survey Explorer, or WISE, and I'm the deputy project scientist for that project. I'm also working on another project to use the WISE data to search for asteroids and comets, and that project is known as NEOWISE, and I'm the principal investigator of the NEOWISE project. My first thought of being an astronomer was when I was about 6 years old. I'd say the single most influential person on my career as a whole has been my mother. My mom is not a scientist. She's an artist by profession, but she's always been interested in things. She loves nature, loves to look at birds and plants, and when I came home one day and said, I want to be an astronomer, she thought, hey, that's great. Go do that. Have fun. Because of that, she really gave me the freedom to pursue my dream. And she was always really happy for me when I was, you know, learning something. And she was really supportive of me when times got tough, when I had really hard problem sets to struggle with in school, you know, when I got my first job. It really made a big difference to have somebody like that in my life. So I remember reading in this particular book about a place called JPL, the Jet Propulsion Lab, and thinking, wow, okay, well, I guess this is where they do this stuff. But I was growing up in Ohio, and JPL was in California, which seemed like it was on the other side of the planet. But I always knew at that point that I would probably need to go there.
Go ahead.
There's a lot of variety, which is what I really like. I mean, one day is never the same as the next. Every day is different, and they're usually really fun. I started off as a kid wanting to work at JPL because of missions like Voyager, and the fact that it's still going on today is incredible to me. Don't be afraid to be curious. Don't be afraid to ask what seems like silly questions. You know, why is the sky blue? I mean, it turns out even those silly questions have really profound and interesting answers, because that at its heart is what science is all about. It's understanding nature and not being afraid to ask why.